In this screencast, I'm going to briefly describe the interactive simulation that represents the Rankine cycle for generating power from steam. It has several options, but we're plotting a pressure enthalpy diagram, the cycle, where at point one, we have high pressure liquid that we, at constant pressure, feed into a boiler, raise it to its boiling point at point two inside the boiler, and then evaporate all the liquid and then superheat it. So leaving the boiler is steam, superheated steam at point three. Then we feed this steam to a steam turbine, which generates work and lowers both the pressure and the temperature, so the enthalpy decreases. And we may end up with superheated steam, or we may end up with saturated steam or steam with quality, depending on the turbine efficiency. And that's one of the sliders that we can change in this simulation. We can also change the outlet pressure as well as the inlet pressure. Once we leave the turbine, then we condense the steam back to a liquid. So we have saturated liquid at 0.5. We can pressurize this back up to high pressure to complete the cycle. So this is a brief description. Now let's look at the actual simulation. So here's the simulation on the Wolfram site. And first we're showing the pressure enthalpy diagram, where we can change the inlet pressure. This is the inlet pressure to the turbine. As we raise the pressure, of course, we're coming in with steam that has higher pressure, higher enthalpy. We can also change the outlet pressure. And if we raise the outlet pressure, we're going to have a smaller pressure drop. We're going to end up getting less work out of the process. And then we can change the efficiency. So this is efficiency relative to reversible process. So this dotted line from starting at 0.3 corresponds to reversible. So if I make the efficiency 0.95, then we're close to reversible. So this is efficiency, that's the fraction of the reversible efficiency, how close we can approach reversible process. So if I lowered efficiency, then we're going to get less work out of this turbine. The other options here are, one, to look at the cycle, where for the conditions we've chosen, we have superheated vapor leaving the turbine, and then saturated liquid that's fed to the pump, where we have high-pressure liquid, and we evaporate it to superheated vapor that we feed to the turbine. And then we also have, as part of the simulation, the conditions. So as we change the pressure here, we're changing the inlet pressure. And that, of course, changes how much work. As we go to higher pressure, we get more work out of the turbine. Likewise, as we go to higher efficiencies, we get more work out of the turbine. And higher efficiencies, then we have a lower temperature leaving the turbine. So you can use these sliders to get a better understanding of the Rankine cycle, which is the simplest version of a cycle using steam to generate work from some high temperature source, such as burning natural gas to heat the steam. And of course, in the cycle, then we need some way to now condense the low pressure steam, such as a large body of water, for example.